due to the final week just before Jesus was crucified and rose again the third day to be our everlasting Lord. My text is Revelation chapter 1, verse 5, which speaks of Jesus Christ, who is the faithful witness and the first begotten of the dead and the prince of the kings of the earth, he who loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood. Twice in the Bible, Jesus is given the title, the faithful witness. Revelation 1, verse 5, Revelation 3, verse 14. Jesus was faithful. Christianity is the record of some who have endured unto the end and of others who have begun well but later have faltered. St. Paul fought a good fight and finished his course. Demas started out well but then fell in love with the world. I want to talk to you about Jesus. The Bible calls him the faithful witness. He was tempted in all points like as we are, but he endured. He was hated without a cause, but he made no concession to the enemy. I invite you to go with me to the Garden of Gethsemane. The Bible tells us what happened. Jesus ate his final meal with the 12. Then he offered them the bread and the wine of his atonement. He preached the sermon contained in John 14-16. And then he prayed the sublime prayer of John 17. After that, he led his disciples to the Mount of Olives, where he told his disciples to watch with him while he went on ahead, found a place to pray, and agonized, sweating great drops of blood dropping to the ground, while God the Father gave him the cup of sin and sorrow and guilt and death and pain for you, for me, for every person who has ever lived on planet Earth. There is no more solemn scene in all the Bible than we find in Gethsemane. Jesus is facing the vicarious death of the cross with its unspeakable terrors. Isaiah tells us that it pleased the Lord Jehovah to bruise him. Jesus did not die a martyr's death. He was our sin bearer. As one great preacher has said, Jesus on Calvary became the world's greatest sinner, for God laid on him the iniquity of us all. All of the devils of hell could not destroy him. Pilate and Herod were just bit players in an eternal drama. It was God who gave Jesus the cup, and in that cup were your sins and mine. And Jesus said, Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me, but not my will, but thine be done. Jesus faced a crisis when he left earth, heaven to come to earth. He faced a crisis at age 12 when he was about his father's business. He faced a crisis at the Jordan when God said, Behold the Lamb of God. When John the Baptist said, Behold the Lamb of God. He faced a crisis in the wilderness when he said no to every temptation of the devil. And he faced a crisis on the mountain as he spoke with Moses and Elijah of his death soon to be accomplished in Jerusalem. But all of those times of crisis pale into insignificance in the garden. When face to face with the cross, Jesus said, Father, if there's no other way to save a lost humanity, I will drink of the cup. I will make my sinless soul an offering for the sins of the world. Jesus was the faithful witness, faithful unto death. My words can never, never tell what it cost him or how much I owe to him. I read that he sweat great drops of blood falling to the ground. Medical science has a name for that. When the pressure gets so great that the arteries and the veins seep blood. Brave men have faced death without complaint, but Jesus was facing infinitely more than just physical death. You will never understand the cross of Christ unless you grasp this fact. that your Savior on Calvary paid for your sin debt in full, all that the justice of God required, so that you might spend eternity in heaven. Have you any idea what debt you owe to Christ? Have you looked into the cup that God gave him to drink in Gethsemane? He set his face as a flint. He turned not back. And at the cross, he made peace with God for earth's vilest sinners. Now, with all of that as a background, I want to suggest some questions and answers for you. Question number one, why didn't Jesus flee to Egypt or to Greece when Caiaphas sought to kill him? Answer, for this cause he came unto this hour. Question number two, what was in the cup that God gave Jesus to drink? Answer, God made him to be sin for us, he who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him. Question number three, why did Jesus tell Peter to put up his sword when soldiers came to arrest him? Answer, his kingdom was not of this world. Question number four, why did Jesus not defend himself when they accused him of blasphemy? Answer, as mankind's sin bearer, he was guilty of every human sin. Question number five, why did he not use his miraculous powers to avoid the cross? Answer, the Son of Man must suffer all of these things and enter into his glory. Question number six, why did Jesus not call 10,000 angels to destroy the world and set him free? Answer, he was wounded for our transgressions and bruised for our iniquities. Question number seven, why didn't Jesus just write pardon across the sky and let all the world go free? Answer, because the wages of sin is death, and without the shedding of blood, there is no remission for sins. Question number eight, why did Jesus claim to be God before the Sanhedrin when he knew that they would condemn himself to death? Answer, he could not deny himself. Question number nine, if the sins of all the world were in that cup, why is not everybody in the world saved? Answer, as many as received him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God. Question number 10, how can I know that God accepted the work of Jesus Christ on the cross for my eternal salvation? Answer, God raised him again from the dead and set him at his own right hand, far above all principality and power and might and dominion and every name that is named in heaven and in the earth, every name in this world and in the world to come. Dear friend, Jesus died for you. On the third day, he rose again. Easter means that Jesus paid it all. There's mercy for you. There's grace for you and for me. There's room at the cross for you. Jesus drank the bitter cup that the Father gave to him in Gethsemane. The blood of Jesus Christ, God's Son. Nothing less, nothing more needed. The blood of Jesus Christ, God's Son, cleanses from all sin. You and I have peace with God. He made peace by the blood of his cross. And you can accept that gift of his peace today.
Thank you.